Significant figures in logarithms and antilogs. In this video, I will be showing you how to properly round calculated answers after you use logarithms or antilogs. I am assuming that you already know what significant figures are and why they're important, and that you can look at a number and determine how many significant figures are in it. If you do not already know those two things, I recommend watching my first two videos in this playlist before you proceed. The first thing you need to know is that there is a different significant figures rule for each mathematical operation. So there is a rule for logs and antilogs, there's a rule for multiplication and division, there is a rule for addition and subtraction. Right now I am only talking about logarithms and antilogs, but our one and only rule is the number of significant figures after the decimal in a calculated log value equals the number of significant figures in the original number. Let's look at some examples involving logarithms. So in this column, I have a bunch of numbers, and in this column, I have the logs of those numbers. In other words, the log of 1.8 times 10 to the minus 9th is equal to negative 8.744727. Our goal is to properly round these numbers. These are the numbers that a calculator would give, and calculators do not care about significant figures. They give as many digits as they possibly can. So we need to apply our rule to round these numbers. One thing I want to point out, these first three numbers, they all have the same coefficient. They are all 1.8 times 10 to some power. And the logarithms of those values all have the same digits after the decimal place. They are all something 0.744727. This means that the coefficient is controlling digits after the decimal, and the exponent is controlling digits before the decimal. That is the key to our rule. So this calculated logarithm has as many significant figures after the decimal place as this original number has in its entirety. So 1.8 has two significant figures. The log of that value has two significant figures after the decimal. We are always considering anything before the decimal point as significant. So overall, this has three significant figures. We need to round this number to negative 8.74. The same applies for these next two. They both have two significant figures in the coefficient, so everything is significant up through two digits after the decimal place. But notice what just happened here. Two of these numbers have three significant figures overall. The third one has four significant figures overall. The constant here is two significant figures in the coefficient of the original number, means two significant figures after the decimal place. Let's look at these last two examples. We have a different coefficient, 6.21, so we have different digits after the decimal place, but same concept applies. The log of 6.21 times 10 to the 8th equals 8.793092. 6.21 has three significant figures, so this log has three significant figures after the decimal point. We need to round this to 8.793. And our final example, 6.21 times 10 to the 102 power, same concept, three significant figures. Everything is significant up through three digits after the decimal place. So this needs to be rounded to 102.793. Now let's work on rounding some antilogs. So logarithms and antilogarithms are reverse of the same processes. So I need to take that rule I gave you earlier and reverse it. But same setup as before. I have values for x, and I have calculated antilogs of those values. So the way that you calculate an antilog when you're talking about log base 10 is to take 10 to the power of that number. So for example, our first number is negative 4.74. The antilog would be 10 to the power of negative 4.74. The answer that a calculator would give you is 1.81970 times 10 to the minus 5th. But let's apply our previous rule in reverse. Think of these as what we were previously calling the calculated log values. What matters here is how many significant figures are after the decimal point. We do not care how many significant figures are before the decimal point. Before the decimal point is controlling this exponent. After the decimal point is controlling the coefficient. So there are two significant figures after the decimal point here. So the antilog of this number needs two significant figures overall. I need to round this to 1.8 times 10 to the minus fifth. Our second example, negative 10.74, still has two significant figures after the decimal. The first number had three significant figures overall, second number had four significant figures overall, but they both have two after the decimal. That is what we care about here. So this antilog that a calculator gives needs two significant figures overall. I need to round this to 1.8 times 10 to the minus 11th. Look at our third and fourth examples. These are both something 0.32. Digits before the decimal point are vastly different, but in the antilog, you are seeing a calculator gives the same coefficients, drastically different exponents. So you can see that the digits before the decimal point are controlling the exponents, digits after the decimal point are controlling the coefficient. But these both have two significant figures after the decimal. Yes, this has three significant figures overall. Yes, this has five overall. We are looking at how many are after the decimal point. So these numbers both have two significant figures overall. So the first one, we need to round this to 4.8 times 10 to the minus fifth. And the second one, we need to round to 4.8 times 10 to the minus 109. Thanks for watching Chemistry in a Nutshell. If you feel that I've earned it, please like this video and subscribe to my channel.